Hey everyone, in this video we will see how the script section in package.json file works. Let's get started. I open the package.json file. Here I have scripts object where I have two commands, that is dev and build. Let me execute this in the terminal. We all know to run the script in the terminal, I need to say npm run and the script name, that is build. This will run webpack build process and give me the output in the dist folder. If I make any changes in my source, and run webpack build again, it will create new set of build files. I don't want this to happen. To solve this problem, in my build script, I'll add an extra command to clean up the dist folder and run the webpack build. Now I'll go back to my source and do some changes. If I execute npm run build, now this folder will be removed and new set of build files will be emitted there. To verify, I'll try this once again. I can see that this folder is removed and new build files are emitted. Now let's move on to another interesting thing about scripts. I have dev script which would run the dev server. So I'll say npm run dev. This will start my dev server on localhost 8080. I'll stop the server. Now, if I directly run webpack serve, I get an error saying webpack command is not found. Do you know why this happens? This is because the script's command will be executed in a different scope. That scope is inside node modules. We have .bin folder. Here, we can see the executables of all the packages which we have installed for this project. Now, I'll run this webpack directly from my terminal. Awesome, this works. The webpack server is running on localhost 8080. I'll stop this. I'll verify with the webpack build. This works too. The commands in the script section will be executed in the .bin scope of the node modules. That's the reason we use scripts and provide all our commands there, instead of navigating to .bin folder in terminal and executing them. That's all folks. Thank you.